Okay, now here we are in the Pain Men's local. What kind of dangers lurk in a pub scenario like this?
Pool, Mark.
God, pool, that's like a gentleman's game. I can't imagine any aggro surrounding pool.
Well, it used to be.
Yeah,
you know, when me and Punch go play pool.
Yeah.
We set the balls up. Mm. He just checks the cushions and the felt to make sure it's okay.
Of course he does.
And while he's doing it, I go bang. Back him on the edge.
What? You fuck him? I'm not familiar with these new rules. Now, Pancho, you're not a bit worried that when you do this, you might suffer permanent injuries to your head?
Well, there's only one way to find out, Mark.
Take it away.
Okay. You want to see me pickle him?
Yeah. No. Yeah. Before we start, please don't try this at home. And well done at home if you've got a pool table. It's going well.
You should be so lucky.
3, 2, 1.
Just do it!
Right, ready?
I got butterflies now.
3, 2, 1.
No!
One.
No! Give me a pain rating out of 10. I know it's hard.
I give my rating out of 10, Mark.
That's an 8 out of 10. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pain Man. Okay, so Pritchard, what other dangers lurk in a pub scenario?
Darts, Mark.
Darts, but that's like a jolly game played by big fat men, isn't it?
Well, no, you could easily mistake that for a human arse.
Wait a minute, with the greatest respect in the world, under what circumstances would you ever confuse like a human arse with a dartboard?
These circumstances.
Okay. Is there not a danger of the owner of that arse not being able to sit down for weeks?
Well, there's only one way to find out, Mark.
OK, Punch, I have asked him to make sure he doesn't get a bullseye.
Oh, thank you, Mark.
You go.
Right, Punch, remember the other day you told me you got some piles?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to fucking pop it.
All right.
Don't try this at home. This is really unwise behaviour. They're trained madmen. Oh, here we go.
I will be no.
There it is.
There it is. Fuck me!
Give me a pain rating out of 10, Eric Bristow.
180, man!
There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pain Man. OK, now, Pancho, what other dangers lurk in a pub environment?
Beer bottles, Mark.
Beer bottles, I completely agree with you. Very dangerous. Give me a scenario that you most fear.
Well, you know, you're sitting down, you're watching Wales absolutely annihilate England in the rugby.
And what happens?
Well, you know, get the beers down your neck. Next thing you know, this horrible fly just comes zzzz in about. It lands on top of your head. And you're so excited, you forget you've got a bottle in your hand, and zap, you smash it over your head.
If, in this environment tonight, we were to try that out with you, Pritchard, are you not worried that maybe we'd crack your head open?
There's only one way to find out, Mark.
OK, fair enough. Now, I just want to confirm everyone knows all sorts of jiggery-pokery goes on in the world of television, and therefore I'm going to explain to you the kind of bottle that's used tonight. This here is what's usually used in television. It's called sugar glass, and it does this. Oh, gosh, it's quite serious, wasn't it? This, however, is a real glass. And it does much more damage. Pritchard, I want you to go over onto this stage area here, far away from our very valuable studio audience who don't want to get glass anywhere. And I want you to imagine there's a fly hovering around your head. I want you to swat it with that bottle. Away you go.
Cheers.
OK, guys, whatever you do, do not try this at home. This man is a trained idiot. Pancho, I think there's a fly over there.
Pritch, it's by you, you.
It's just next to you here, mate. Get the fly.
Oh, you idiot! No, he's not there! He's on the top of your head!
The fly is on the top of your head.
Right the fly. The top!
Pain rating out of 10.
I'll give out a 9 out of 10, Mark.
Don't try it at home, and it's a silly waste of beer. Ladies and gentlemen, the Pain Men. Yeah.